I'm standing here in front of my entire hydronic heating system. This has been something we've been working hard on for quite some time, and we are 95% done on the install. We've got a Navien boiler here that makes our hot water. We have multiple zones, it's two zones. We have a floor heating, radiant floor heating zone here, and then we have a secondary zone right here that makes hot water that it's sending up into the attic for the air handler. It's a Carrier Infinity system, and there's a hydronic coil that's hooked up to that system. The last step in what we're doing, we need the Carrier Infinity system up in the attic to be able to communicate with the boiler down here so that when it needs the boiler to start heating water and sending hot water up to the Infinity system in the attic, it can tell the boiler, turn on the pumps, start sending water up. So how do we do that? Well, in order for this to work, we need a hydronic relay in the attic. The Hydronic Relay Kit that Carrier used to sell, they stopped manufacturing back in 2016. And it's near impossible to find one of these unless you're, I guess, a reseller or something like that. So anyway, the Hydronic Relay Kit consists of a relay device, a control board, and a wiring harness. That, as a whole, used to exist. Now, when you try and order anything, the replacement parts, you get them as piecemeal. So we're ultimately going to be rebuilding this entire thing from the parts and pieces that we've gotten. I want you guys to understand what goes into building this and what you need to do if you want to recreate this for your system. All right, so our goal here is to build this entire wiring harness, relay, and control board. Luckily, looking around online, I was able to find a wiring diagram for the entire wiring harness, how it goes into the various pin connectors, the 12-pin connector, how it wires up to the relay, how it wires up to the board. But then there's this question right here, this ID. The whole purpose of the ID is to tell the air handler upstairs and the thermostat upstairs that it's connected to a hydronic coil rather than an electric heating element. So I was always confused about what this ID was, and I couldn't get any answers anywhere online to define what that ID was. What was it that would tell the air handler that I was connecting to a hydronic coil? It wasn't until I found this dealer service bulletin from way back in 2013, I think. It outlines that there was a mistake and there was a ID resistor that was being put into some of the units that was 270 ohms as opposed to a 270,000 ohm or 270k ohm resistor. So that's when I realized what we're looking for is a resistor. The resistor is the ID. So I was able to order 270 ohm resistors. And if you look closely at this element here, there's this black wire here. It's a heat shrinked wire right here. That's the ID, that's the resistor that goes on here. So I believe if I create this wiring harness, wire it up to the control board and the relay, and include a resistor right here, then we should be in good shape. And I've got to go ahead and create this whole thing. In order to create the Hydronic Relay Kit, we're going to need several items. First, we need the relay itself. Next, we're going to need the control board. Control board hooks straight up to the relay. After that, we're going to need several spools of wires to create the overall harness. Next, we're going to need a 12-pin connector. This will connect up to the wiring harness that's in the air handler right now. We're going to need the connectors for inside of that wiring harness. The final item that we're going to need is a 2-pin connector. There are two pins right here. These pins have to connect to the air handler. I was able to find a 2-pin, 5mm pitch connector that I'll be able to feed the wires in right here. And then the connector on this side feeds right on to those two pins and hooks up nicely. Finally, we're gonna need a little bit of solder. Soldering iron, some heat shrink, and the heat gun. A couple of these female disconnect pairs that'll connect right here onto the wiring harness. All right, one thing I did was I took a reference photo of the current clip that's actually installed. So if you see the orientation of this clip installed here off the reference photo, you've got this little ridge right here That means that black wire goes here into pin connection 7, and then yellow wire goes to pin connection 9. So the orientation of this to the wiring diagram is right here, starting with pin 1 where the little ridge is. So that's important to note. Everything else is based off of that ordering.
Making the wiring harness is a pretty straightforward process. I started with the black and yellow wires. These wires connect to the 240 volt hot wires from the breaker and offer the power supply for the fan coil. The wiring harness comes with small male connectors that are pinched onto the wires and then slip into each connection of the 12 pin connector. This way you only need to make the connections you need for your harness. There are two small fins on the side of the metal connectors that allow the pins to snap securely into place. The next two wires I made up were the white and blue wires for pins 2 and 3. These two wires are how the motherboard for the air handler communicate with the relay board. In order to connect the ID wiring, I used two lengths of red wire connected to pins 5 and 8. I left the ends of these two lengths disconnected so that I can solder in the 270k ohm resistor as the ID later. The control board friction fits onto the connectors of the relay device, and then I connected the white and blue wires into the 2-pin connector, which is then push fit onto the two pins on the top of the control board. The relay connection is made using a white and red wire and two of the female crimp disconnects that attach to the posts of the relay board. These two wires are what connect to the boiler or pump relay. When the thermostat calls for heat and the hydronic coil needs hot water, this circuit is closed and instructs the boiler and pump to turn on and begin circulating that hot water. Finally, the 270k ohm resistor needs to be soldered onto the ends of the two red wires. Before connecting anything, I slide a piece of heat shrink down the wire so we can conceal the whole thing when done. After twisting on the resistor to the ends of the wires, I'm using my Milwaukee cordless soldering iron to make a permanent connection. Now that the solder has cooled, we just need to slide the heat shrink wrap over the resistor and expose wiring to protect it from touching anything conductive, warm it, and have it shrink down onto the wire. This is the completed hydronic kit and wiring harness. While I would have liked to have been able to purchase this as a single unit, since it's no longer available as a kit, making it ourselves is the only option. Next, I'll have to install this newly created relay kit in the air handler. I'll remove the wiring harness that's there right now and replace it with this kit. I'll have to connect the yellow and black wires to the power for the unit, then connect up the red and white wires to the boiler pump wires, and then we should be good to go. Our air handler is in our attic space and has a sub panel with breaker nearby that feeds its power. After turning off the power to the air handler, the install of this relay kit is very simple. Disconnect the 240 volt wires and discard the current wiring harness. I first need to run the thermostat wire from the boiler into the air handler in order to connect the communication leads. Then I just need to make a few simple connections to the wiring leads on the kit. In order to make sure everything stays secure, I mounted the relay kit to the internal wall of the air handler using some zip-in metal screws. After making the connections and mounting the device, all that's left is to turn on the power. The unit will immediately begin the power-up portion self-test, and the lights will begin flashing on the motherboard. Just replace the panel, head down to the thermostat to complete the configuration. After installing the relay kit in the unit, the system will automatically restart, sense a configuration change, and begin the setup process again. It will walk itself through several screens where it detects the outdoor unit, followed by the SAM module, and then performs a zoning search. When the setup prompts, just move on to the next screen. Since the system was previously configured, all of the prior selections should be maintained and just need to be confirmed. This makes it pretty quick and easy to step through the entire process. After the equipment summary, the system begins an airflow verification test that may take up to about 10 minutes to complete. In our case, we received an airflow test warning regarding the blower RPM. This is indicative of high static pressure in the system and was likely due to a combination of an air filter that needed to be changed and also the additional resistance that often happens with a hydronic coil. It's very important to change your filter frequently when using multiple coils. Once your tests and initial setup are complete, the system will recognize that you have a hydronic coil installed and you can move onto the hydronic configuration. By entering the menu and selecting the icon that's labeled heat source, you can see the heat sources the system sees as available. At this point, we have the options system in control, hot water only, and heat pump only. We want to leave system in control selected so that we won't need to make any changes based on the outdoor temperature or when the seasons change. Next, we'll enter the configuration screen by going through the service menu icon. Rather than just touching this icon, you need to hold your finger on the icon until the background turns green in about 10 seconds. Once it's green, just lift your finger and you'll go into the service configuration. Within the service configuration screen, I'm most concerned with the heat source lockout options. This setting defines when the system will use the heat pump, hydronic coil, or a combination of both as the heat source for the unit. In our case, I'm going to set the hydronic lockout at 50 degrees, which means the system will only use the hydronic coil when the outdoor temperature is below 50. For the heat pump, I'll set the lockout at 40 degrees. This means the system will only use the heat pump when it's above 40 outside. When the outdoor temperature is between 40 and 50 degrees, the system will be able to use a combination of the hydronic coil and heat pump as the heat source. Saving the settings, I'll return to the main menu and turn the system back on by selecting auto. I'll then increase the set temperature for the unit to 70 degrees and the system should call for heat. Since it's 48 degrees outside, the system will use both the hydronic coil and the heat pump for the heat. As you can see, building this relay kit is not difficult if you know the parts and pieces you'll need and how to assemble them. Now our heat pump with hydronic coil will be able to easily keep up with the heating needs of our house and will be able to do it efficiently and economically.